Mr. President. Happy to serve.
Mr. President.
How are you?
Well, come in.
Thank you.
Somebody take chair over there.
I know.
How are you doing?
Good to see you. How you doing? How's it going?
Pretty well.
Good. Well, we appreciate a chance to talk to you, Mr. President.
Well, I've been looking forward to this.
Senator.
I'm surprised you're going to say that.
Good. Senator Heck originally introduced a bill which would return to the state in all rural areas the opportunity to raise the speed limit to 65 on all roads up to the state. And as a compromise in the Public Works Committee, I introduced a bill that just affected the interstates in areas of population centers less than 50,000. And then we met with Secretary Dole. Was it time is all? Was it Saturday night? So we were over at the Senate it was the other, and discussed some of the pros and cons of it, but we really believe that the time is right to turn this back to the states where it belongs.
Well, now, the only place where I differ with you is, and I think it's time that we simply lifted on all rural highways our federal limited law and left it up to the state center to determine what they wanted.
May I endorse your proposal?
I endorse that.
I endorse that, 100%.
All right.
Okay. I would like to have, are we going to non-union join us?
Made some notes because my brain isn't so good that I can remember things in this.
Poor guy just flew in. He flew in especially for this. He's had a wedding in the family. Yeah.
Oh, for heaven's sakes.
So I did the red eye from California.
Oh, boy.
You know that one.
I've managed to avoid that.
Well, boy,
I can for the rest of my life, yes.
It's
different. Maureen travels it all the time, and I don't know how the hell she does it.
She's young. That's the answer to that.
Thank you for seeing us. This is my son, Brock.
Hello there.
This is President Reagan.
Nice to see you.
This is my wife, Gail.
Hi, Gail.
We've met before.
Yes.
This is your number one fan, Allison.
Yes.
Allison has admired you since she was 4 years old, which
and
was some
it's
years
happy
ago.
Happy birthday today, isn't it?
Yesterday for her.
It's you.
Yes. This is Courtney, who is a great admirer.
I just missed by one.
That's right. Well, Courtney wrote the original letter to ask for the chance to meet you, and it was a little handwritten letter, so. We appreciate
Father
you doing it.
Very big help to me, and I'm most grateful. I know sometimes it must be a strain having a public official in the family.
Yeah. It's more of a strain than they probably would like to say right now.
Why don't you all come in here and get in here with us? And
Brian, you stand, Allison, you stand over here.
Maybe somebody on the other side over here, right? Access to the White House. Well, tomorrow
and
evening
we
is going to be a barbecue.
We're ready
to
go.
Thank you very much. Thank you for letting us come today.
Pleased to be here.
Thank you. Ms. President, keep up the good work.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
That ought to do it.
I don't know when you're getting back to California, but I'm leaving here Saturday.
I'm leaving here Saturday also, yeah.
Well, listen,
delighted to get out of here.
Well,
we're trying. And, we have good days and bad days, but it's working out. We'll try to get there. Okay, well, thanks. Good luck to you. Have fun in California. We will too.
I'm coming.
Okay, great. Good to see you. Thanks a lot.
Mr. President.
Mr. President, Congressman John Lafalce.
John Lafalce. How are you, Mr. President?
Very good.
Thank you
for that help.
Oh, you're very welcome, Mr. President. I just want to make a few points. I had opposed protectionism, which is why it was easy for me to support you on that.
so I don't have to worry about that. I really think we need an alternative to protectionism. And we've had so much protectionism, even though you've strongly opposed it, voluntary quotas, railroads, steel, Harley Davidson, the textile treaties, whether bilateral or multilateral, are protectionism in itself. I've been promoting the concept I call competitiveness. Everybody should favor that. A lot of people have given it a bad name, but they call it industrial policy, which conjures up the worst type of government planning, et cetera. Your own commission chairman, said we need a mechanism consistent with labor management to help promote competitiveness. He's a little disappointed in the follow-through we've had to his recommendation, so he's created his own private sector center on industrial competitiveness here in Washington. The problem is, I know what's going to happen. It's going to go toward protectionism. Unless you can establish an executive order or a law that says the three of us, government, labor, management, work together to promote competitiveness, you're always going to wind up fighting on protectionism. There's a bill to be strongly opposed, the trade bill. Now, a good compromise to that, what you would consider a bad trade bill, might be some mechanism to bring government
President, how are you? Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
First time I'm working. President, this is a great honor.
Well, listen,
I can't tell you.
Not only honored to see you, but deeply grateful. I know that that was intended for a birthday. Well, I don't mind celebrating all year.
Why not?
Thank you.
Well, accepted in good health, and I just want you to know that we deeply appreciate all of the never-ending efforts that you've given in your job, and there's an awful lot of people out there that think you're the best president we've ever had, and I certainly agree with him. We want you to keep up the good work.
Thank you very much.
Positive.
Why don't we get a picture of
okay.
this?
Okay, good. What are they with it? Okay.
Right.
Keeping the tradition of the whites alive.
Yes.
We have many famous artists, and he's one of the best. We do appreciate you taking the time.
It's a great honor to be able to present this to you, Mr. President. Keep up the good work.
I'm indebted to you.
We hope
thank
you
for bringing
thank
me
you,
here.
Mr. President. God bless you.
And we voted cloture, as you know.
Oh, yeah. Got my little button on for you. God bless.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. President, Congressman Don Ritter.
Hi. Pennsylvania. Very good to see you, sir.
Good to see you.
I wondered if we could get a piece of paper like that, sit down, and I can be essentially telling you about the problems of the challenges of the Great
sure.
Lehigh Valley of
so
Pennsylvania and northeast part of the country that's heavy into manufacturing. We have a lot of apparel, so I couldn't be with him on that one, but I think if you look at the state of Pennsylvania, Don Ritter's voting record is about as strong as anybody's.
Yes.
I got the most democratic labor district in the country, occupied by somebody who voted like Ronald Reagan.
Well, I know that you've been a great help, and I appreciate it very much.
We think the world of you there. It's a democratic heartland, but those are the kind of votes we have to get if we want to be the majority party. I'm just going to mention a couple of things. Our steel situation, as you know, with this bankruptcy business, is grim.
Yes.
We got the weakest producers going Chapter 11 and coming back as the lowest cost producers, and no one's going to have a business. We need to plan something to rationalize that industry and just reduce the factories about 40 million tons over.
That's you.
That's me.
I know, of course, you know, one thing is not mentioned about that is one of the main problems with steel, there's no way around this, is that the demand for steel is just not as great
right.
because of the aluminum and plastics
right.
we're out of use
yeah.
and so forth. And it's a little bit like that market. They're producing more than there's a market.
Yes, indeed. And unless we somehow people go out of the business. Everybody's going to be a marginal producer, and
the whole industry is going to be built, just like Badham is talking today. I'm also real interested. I'm the only scientist in the Congressional. I love real low tax rates. Jack Kemp came in campaign for me in the morning, who I was, to be the 16-year incumbent. And we're going to be working on it.
Well, I know that we have to have a steel industry, and we have we've done some things very quietly with the voluntary.
You've done a great job, and
the anti-dumping. But we have to, I think we do have to face that there is going to be a reduced demand.
Yes. Well, there is, but the problem is the supply is not reducing. People are going out of business, but coming back reincarnated is healthier than the people who held on in the first place.
Yeah.
Well, thank you very, very much. I really appreciate
right.
it. And you've got a friend in Pennsylvania, in the Lehigh Valley.
All right. Thank you for coming down.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Man, is this my family?
Yes.
Well, I'm not part of the family. Rosemary Cribble. I'm sorry that my husband is up there voting, not able to join us. But we are very proud of our Virginia here. I wanted to be here to share in this congratulations. It's a special moment for her.
And you were one yourself?
Oh, ages ago.
Not that long.
Please meet her family.
Hello.
Hi, Vivian. Wonderful.
It's nice to see you.
Nice to meet you.
How are you?
Mr. President, I need to fix Mr. Hughes.
This is a special venture. My brother came all the way from Fort Benning at Airborne School.
I was going to say, I thought he must be in the military.
Yes, indeed, sir. Got off training today to come and see you.
Well, why don't one of us come over here and we'll kind of know. No one
why don't you put me on the opposite side?
We'll switch out now here. This will work out and we'll have some.
Okay.
Thank you.
There are two quick things I'd like to share with you if you have time. I know you're busy. But I flew back today from the National Junior Achievement Conference, and it was so special. I'd like to thank you for what you've done for the morale and patriotism in our country. 2,100 students last night were arm in arm singing God Bless America and then chanting USA. It just gives me chills.
Listen, I had some of those chills myself. You know, when I was governor of California, if I went to a campus, they hung me in effigy. had a riot. But lately I've made some appearances, and I hear the students, instead of applauding, chanting USA. I get goose pimples.
You shared that story with the Trust the other day, and I really, so many talked about that afterwards, about he had just landed, and all the young people had come forward, and just really showed how proud they are to have him not only as our political and government leader, but as our moral leader as well. And we are behind you 100%. The second thing is the Junior Miss program has 30,000 high school senior girls nationwide. And this year I'm instituting a new program against drug abuse like you are.
Hey.
And one of the things that I'm doing is with peer pressure and exciting the girls who are from different high schools. So 30,000 high schools nationwide will be hopefully instituting drug programs this year to encourage.
That's great because that I think people just had Mr. Ueberroth of the baseball is coming in here on this and was pointing out the very thing that I agree with. That we can, at the government level, we can do the things like trying to shut it off and arrest and intercepting the drugs. But to get the customers to turn away from it has got to be from the private sector. There's got to be a willingness out there on the part of the people.
What I'm excited is that our own age group will be working with the peers to excite them about.
That's wonderful.
Going straight. And if there's anything that the Junior Miss Program or I can do, please let me know. I'm real excited that you and Mrs. Reagan are working so hard on this, and we will be too.
Well, it sounds like you're already doing it. That's great. Listen, just a few souvenirs here.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you.
Just a little souvenir of a visit to the Oval Office.
Thank you so much.
And a keychain.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Seal on it. And a bookmark for you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
And members of
I'm
Congress.
Here. I'm here. And I know you've seen many of these, but this is the Just Say No button that I wore during rehearsals. I wanted to share that with you.
Do you know where that came from, that line?
From Mrs. Reagan.
Yeah, but you know how it was done?
How did it start?
She was taught to some students in Oakland, California. And a question came from the audience about, well, what do we do and so forth? And Nancy said, just say no.
That's right.
And there are now 10,000 just say no clubs in the
country. That's exciting.
That is exciting. This is the one I wore during rehearsal, and is it proper to pin it on the president? This is really an honor. Thank you. And I'm flying back to the Junior Achievement Conference this afternoon, and they send you their best, and were wondering if you had anything to say to them.
Well, yes. Please give them my very best regards and my thanks for what they're doing.
Okay, thank you, I will.
Your generation may be the one that's going to turn this around. You know, it happened once before, way back around the turn of the century. And cocaine was the villain then. Mm-hmm. And all of a sudden, there just came along a generation of young people that said enough already.
Oh, I sure
wiped
so.
It out.
Oh, great. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you. Congratulations.
Thanks so much.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Mr.
Privilege
President.
It's an honor to be here.
It's a pleasure to see you.
Certainly an honor to meet you, Mr. President.
Well, Rob,
I had 150 push-ups to get up here. You're all the girls wouldn't believe, but I was really coming to see you today. I said, where are you going tomorrow? How come you're not going to be here? I said, I'm going to go see the president. He said, get the front line rest. I can't believe this. 150 push-ups later, I finally convinced him. Here I am.
So they said he was coming to see the commander in chief, and I just thought that was a big turning. Uh-oh, something else is coming your way. You have just made a young man's day.
Certified. C-E-R. Not E. C-E-R.
T-I-F-I-D.
T-I-F-I-D.
F-Y.
Oh, wait a minute. I started to...
There we go.
Isn't that awful? It's so long since I have to write words myself. That...
Rob Smith.
And any designation, cadet or
cadet would be this one. Yes, sir.
Smith.
Yes, sir.
I think this is gonna have to be Xerox before I can really step back.
Suitable for framing. Huh?
That's right.
Wonderful example to our nation, to the young people. We're very proud of her.
I think that is so. I agree.
Well, thank you.
And I think there's a couple of proud parents.
You bet.
All right.
Thank you so much, Mr. President.
You bet.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. God bless you.